Hey everyone, in this video, I'm going to show you how to index a vector in MATLAB. First, I'll define a vector, then I'll explain vector index notation, and finally, I'll show you how to access a single element, more than one element, and a range of elements from a vector in MATLAB. Let's get started. A vector is a two-dimensional array that has a size of 1 by n or n by 1. A row vector has a size of 1 by n, and a column vector has a size of n by 1. We can use index notation to reference a specific element using a subscript. The subscript I is called the index, and we can assume the index runs from 1 to n. So a1 is the first element, a2 is the second element, and an is the nth element in vector A. Now that I've explained vector index notation, let's head over to MATLAB. Now that we're in MATLAB, we're going to create a row vector with 5 elements and assign them to the variable A. A is assigned the value of. To create a row vector, separate the elements by a comma or a space and enclose them in square brackets. Our elements are 8, 6, 7, 5, and 3. And now we've created a row vector and assigned it to the variable A. To reference a specific element, enter the name of the vector variable followed by the index in parentheses. For a row vector, the index is the column number. For a column vector, the index is the row number. MATLAB uses one-based indexing. In other words, the first element in a vector has an index of 1. So a 1 is the first element in row vector A, which has a value of 8. You can use the keyword end as an index to reference the last element in a vector. So A end is the last element in row vector A, which has a value of 3. To reference a single element, simply enter the row or column number as the index. So A3 is the third element in row vector A, which has a value of 7. To reference more than one element, specify the indices in a vector. The indices may be separated by a comma or a space and should be enclosed in square brackets. So A1, 3 references the first and third element in row vector A and is a subsequence of the vector. The first element has a value of 8, and the third element has a value of 7. The colon operator can be used to reference a range of elements or a subarray. So A2:4 refers to the second through the fourth element in the vector, which have values of 6, 7, and 5. The colon operator can also be used as an index to reference all of the elements in a vector. So A: refers to all of the elements in row vector A. Because A was a row vector, the elements were reshaped to a column vector. All right, that's it. I hope this video provided you with a good introduction to indexing vectors in MATLAB. Thanks for watching. If you liked this video and want to see more, subscribe below. If you would like to support the channel, leave a super thanks in the comments, or click join to become a member. You can find me online and on social media at David Calamus and Spartan Professor.